So I'm showing you the chart of the US 10-year yield, but I just wanted to talk about the 10-year yield and gold, because the two move in the opposite direction. So here we have the 10-year yield, and you can see that the rally since last year is 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. I expect it is an impulse wave. And we had a very long and powerful third wave, that this one here, wave 3, and you can see the RSI was overbought for a long time, and it's pulling back because the pullback here is wave 4. Okay, so if you compare this chart to the gold chart, you will note that the bottom here, bottom of wave 2 in yield, was in August 2020, and at the same time, gold peaked, and while the yield were rallying, gold was in a downtrend. So gold has been declining since August. It's just recently that we had a pullback in yield, and that's why gold is rallying. But as you can see on this chart, I expect a move up in yields. So we are currently near the end of the fourth wave, and I think that the 10-year yield is going to move to 2%. So it means that it's going to go above the top of wave 3 and carry on higher. And because I'm expecting a move up in yield, I think gold will go down. So I'm going to go to the chart of gold. And here you will see that based on Elliott Wave analysis, you can see this correction in gold. And you can see that was August 2020. So gold has been in a decline, but it is not an impulsive decline. This is in terms of Elliott Wave. We've got two types of wave, impulse wave and corrective wave. And here it's more like a corrective wave because of the overlap. What I mean by overlap is ABC, XABC. So overlap is because the wave B will overlap the previous wave. Like, for example, it doesn't go in five waves. And you can see there are many overlaps, like A and B. Look at B. It's very high. So basically, this is the structure of a corrective wave. It's going down. And what I mean by impulse wave in terms of Elliott wave is when the fourth wave does not overlap the first wave. So, for example, B is here, top of wave B, and here is C. So we are going down in wave C, and it is an impulse wave, that one, because we've got 1, 2, 3 here and 4. But you can see that the bottom of wave 1 at 1803 has not been breached yet. Okay, it came very close, but it's still intact. So it means that that was the third wave, and that rally since March is the fourth wave, wave 4, and it's in three waves, A, B, and C. And as I was saying, there is no overlap, because right now, so far, you know, the high of that move, I think, is 98. So it means that because the bottom of wave 1 remains intact, it means that we can still assume that we are in an impulse wave down, and the rally is wave 4. And because I was talking about the yields, and the yields, I expect the yields to go higher, this means that gold will decline to complete wave 5 of C. So we can see this big correction since August last year, A, B, C, X, A, B, and C. This is like a double zigzag. And this final wave down, it should go to maybe 1650, I would say, somewhere around that level. The only problem here is that wave 4, which is that rally since March, is a bit large, you know, in terms of time and also magnitude, because you can see it's done a big move. I mean, it's not very big, but it's still, for a fourth wave, it's a big move up. And that's the only thing that is a bit, I would say, not textbook, but, you know, as long as the bottom of wave 1 is not which we can still assume that this is a fourth wave app. And if I go to the other chart, the 120 minutes, which is the chart that will zoom in on that move here, wave 4 circle. If I go to that chart, you can see here A, B, and C, and C should be in 5 wave, and it is in 5 wave, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, and there is no overlap either. Now if I go to the top of wave 1, okay, 1758, and you can see wave 4 ended above that level. So this is an impulse wave, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, which is the structure of wave C. And wave C is the last leg up inside wave 4. So hopefully gold has turned that and gold will decline further to go to 60-50. This is the target. So that is my interpretation of the Elliott wave on gold.